Text number Utsayanischaya Yesterday we heard that there were six principles which were unfavorable.
昨天呢, 我们讲了,
six things that we must try to give up.
这样的六种事情我们应该试图的去停止做, 放弃它。
Like too much eating.
比方说是吃的太多,
too much effort to collect funds.
就是做很大的努力去存很多的钱.
Talking unnecessarily.
闲扯世俗的话题.
Association with worldly minded people.
与那些世俗的人进行交往联谊.
Do you remember those?
你们大家都记得这些吗?
So today we are hearing six things which are favorable.
那今天呢, 我们来看一看, 有哪六件事项做的话, 有利于履行纯粹的奉爱服务。
I said it was like two sides of the same coin.
那我曾经说过, 这个就像一个硬币的正反两面一样。
Now we will turn the coin over.
那我们现在呢, 就是看那一面。
And the first thing it says that is very helpful is to be enthusiastic.
那第一个有利于履行奉爱服务的呢, 是要热情。
We see, especially among persons when they first come, they are generally very enthusiastic.
那我们可以看到, 那些个刚刚来的人啊, 一般的情况下都是很热情的。
But it is not always easy to maintain enthusiasm.
但是要是, 想保持一直热情的话, 不是一件容易的事。
Because so many obstacles come in the way of devotional life.
因为在这个奉爱的这种生活当中, 有很多的,障碍。
One of the things which makes one enthusiastic is to see the Krishna consciousness movement expand.
那在就是热情这方面有一件事情可以让我们热情, 那就是看到 Krishna 意识, 不断的在拓展。
Just like if you see many new persons coming and taking interest, that gives you enthusiasm that yes, there must be something very wonderful here. Otherwise, why so many people are coming?
就像是当我们看到很多的新人来到这里, 来聆听有关 Krishna的事情, 我们必然就会感到肯定就想, 这个事情肯定是很, 很奇妙, 很完美的, 要不然怎么会有那么多的人到这儿来呢?
For many years, in Taiwan, we were trying to, we did not get much result in preaching. Not very many new people were coming.
那我们在台湾呢, 就是传教了很多年, 但是呢, 没有多少新人来。
Now, so many people are coming.
现在呢, 有那么多的人来了。
And similarly, we see in Calcutta, so many young men and a few young ladies are also joining.
那同样呢, 加尔各答也是一样, 我们看到, 些那个, 青年的男女都来, 来参加, Krishna Ishi.
But that happens in waves. It comes and goes, just like the ocean. Sometimes the tide comes in, and sometimes the tide goes out.
但是这种事情是很正常的, 就像海洋那个波浪, 有的时候, 有, 有的时候没有。
So the point is that we have to remain enthusiastic no matter what the condition or result. results are.
那个要点是, 无论发生什么样的情况, 我们都应该始终保持我们的热情。
So what is the basis of, what is the source of enthusiasm?
那么这个要保持热情的那个源泉是哪的,是什么呢?
The source of enthusiasm comes from the attractiveness of Krishna.
那个热情的根源是对Krishna意识感兴趣, 对Krishna就是被Krishna所吸引。
Just like if you see two people who are in love, they are always feeling very enthusiastic to be with each other.
就像我们看到一对这个情侣啊,坠入情网的这个情侣, 他们两个总是特别的热情, 老是想见面, 互相想在一起。
It doesn't matter what is happening besides anything else in the world, but they're eagerness to be with each other is very powerful.
那这两个人呢,不管世上发生什么样的事情, 他们两个都是特别渴望能够见面。
Or I can give a more mundane example.
或者呢,我可以举更多的世俗的例子来说明。
Sex life.
比方说性生活。
We see, well, let's say it this way, we see in the Western world,
我们可以看看西方社会。
Everybody more or less in this room. It excuses mostly everybody in
this room.
Because you are from Asia.
So
you don't have to worry that I'm insulting you.
So you can
laugh at the Europeans and Americans.
我们现在可以嘲笑那个美国人和那个欧洲人。But
Prabhupada gives an example that he has seen that in the Western countries, even old people remain very eager to enjoy sex life.
但是帕帕就举例子说，在西方世界啊，西方的国家，即使是特别老的人了，他对那个性还是特别的渴望。And
it is found that they old men will even go to the clubs just to see young women.
而且呢，我们可以看到有一些个已经老的不行的那些人了，还要去那个俱乐部啊，只是为了看一眼，在那个俱乐部里的年轻女孩子。
Prabhupada tells the story of the famous king. Who was that? Was it? No, was it Akbar? King Akbar, a famous Muslim king in India.
那帕帕就讲了一个就是回教的那个一个国王，他叫。
And he asked his minister that how long is this sex life, interest in sex life, how long does it go on for?
那他就这个国王呢，他就问他的大臣说，对这个性生活的这种兴趣，他能够保持多久？
Because he could understand that it is a disturbing thing.
因为他能够体会到这件事情实际上是打扰他的事情。So
then the minister was very intelligent. He told the king, you bring your young, beautiful daughter, when I call her, you bring her to where I call her. Come with her and watch what happens.
他说那个大臣呢就很有智慧的就回答说，就是当我叫你的时候，你呢就带着你的那个年轻的女儿来。So
the king suddenly received the call from Akbar to bring his, from the minister to bring his daughter to the presence of a dying man.
那有一天呢，那个大臣就叫这个国王，国王带着他的女儿，那么他就跟着这个大臣就到了一个快死的男人的面前。
And when the king and his daughter came in the room, the man was about to die, and rarely can you get to see a king, but instead of looking at the king, the dying man immediately looked upon the beautiful daughter.
那那个到了这个他们国王和那个女儿到了那个快死的人面前呢，那个快死的那个男人他本来是很难看到国王的，但是呢，国王到他面前了，他却不看国王，反而看那个他的美丽的女儿。
So Rupa Goswami says that if you have any attraction, family, friendship, for society, for all the beautiful things of this world, don't go to the bank of the Jamuna River, where Govinda is standing, playing on his flute.
那个Rupa Goswami就说, 一个人如果对自己的这个家庭、社会、国家, 以及世上这个世俗世界里面的所谓美丽的事物还感兴趣的话, 请不要到亚穆纳河边去, 因为那个美丽的Govinda他站在那儿在吹笛子。
Govinda is a name for Krishna, another name.
那Govinda是Krishna的另外一个名字。
Why is Rupa Goswami saying that we shouldn't go to the bank of the Jamuna to see Govinda?
那为什么Rupa Goswami要说, 如果我们对那些事物感兴趣, 我们就不应该到亚穆纳河边去, 因为Govinda在那边站着吹笛子。
Because Govinda is so beautiful that by seeing him, we will lose attraction for all other beautiful things of this world.
因为Govinda它是那么的美丽, 只要我们看它一眼, 我们马上就会失去对这个世俗世界里面所有的所谓的美丽的事物的兴趣, 马上就失去了。
Another name for Krishna is Madan Mohan.
那Krishna的另外一个名字叫 Madan Mohan.
And this means the attractor of Cupid, the bewilderer of Cupid.
那这个Madamoha的意思就是说, 那个能够甚至迷惑, 吸引丘比特的人。
Who is this equivalent in China of Cupid?
那个在中国那个丘比特爱神是谁啊?
Cupid in... So Cupid makes everyone become overwhelmed with desire for the opposite sex. But Cupid becomes overwhelmed by the beauty of Krishna.
我们都知道那个丘比特他是爱神，那一天到晚拿着剑，就是让双方最后就迷惑了，异性的双方坠入爱河了。但是就连丘比特本人都被 Krishna 的美丽所吸引。
So the source of our enthusiasm, if it is to be, if we are to remain always enthusiastic, then we have to learn to connect with Krishna, who is the source of attraction and enthusiasm.
那如果我们要想保持始终保持热情的话，我们就必须要始终能够跟这个热情和美丽的泉源 Krishna 那个联系上。
And the process of doing that is called sadhana bhakti.
那么要想做到这一点的那个程序范文叫 sadhana bhakti.
Beginning with hearing and chanting Krishna's glories.
Sadhana bhakti 的这个程序的开始就是。 聆听吟诵吟唱有关 Krishna 的名字和逍遥时光。
Now you are in the presence of advanced devotees in the holy dham.
那你们大家所有在座的各位呢，现在有机会能够在圣地和有就是资深的奉献者在一起。
This is a time to pray for the right thing.
这个呢，是我们能够向 Krishna 祈祷正确的事情的时候。 这个是我们祈祷正确的事情的时候。Remember,
I'm the lecturer.
So,他没说Krishna，我说Krishna，他说他是讲课的。You
are giving the purport. What should we pray? Are we going to pray? Oh, I have it. Just like you, there are two young devotees who will come from Calcutta, Tina and Gopam.
那我们应该祈祷什么呢？就比方说有两个年轻的奉献者，Tina和Fanta。They
always pray, please bless us that we can do good in our exams.
他们一直是祈祷说，请祝福我们，让我们能够成为一个好的榜样，让我们能够通过考试。So
naturally, because I have so much affection for them, then I say, all right, I'll give you my blessing for that.
那很自然的，因为Gurudev特别的爱他们，自然就给了他们那个祝福。But
Prabhupada said that if you go to someone who is very, very wealthy, you should not ask them simply for 10 rupees or for 100 Taiwanese dollars.
但是其实不应该这么做，如果你遇上一个特别有钱的人，你不应该只是向他要10个ruby或者是100个那个新台币。
I think that Tina and Gopal should ask for a much bigger blessing.
所以呢，他说，我认为那个 Tina 和 Gopal 呢，应该是向我要求更好的祝福。
If you ask, when you come to the holy place and you pray, I want long life or good health or wealth, you may get these things, but they are not the great boon that can be gotten.
那么，如果我们到圣地来祈祷说，能不能让我长寿啊，身体好啊，有钱呐，等等，你可能你能够得到这些事情，但是呢，这个不是你该得到的最好的东西。Krishna
says that he's willing to give you the highest of all material things, liberation, very easy.
Krishna 说，他就是。 可以就是给我们这个物质利益最高的物质利益，也就是解脱，很轻易的他就给我们，可以。
But what is the greatest boon which Krishna is wants to give but doesn't give easily?
那个 Krishna 的什么是最好最高级的祝福，而 Krishna 不那么轻易的给我们呢？
Love for Krishna.
那就是对 Krishna 的爱。
So this is what we should pray for.
我们实际上应该向祈祷，就是说得到对 Krishna 的爱。
We should pray for pure Krishna bhakti, nothing else.
我们应该祈祷能够得到对 Krishna 纯粹的爱，而不应该祈祷其他。
Even if everything else fails, we should pray for this, and this will keep us always enthusiastic.
那不管什么事情不好的事情发生，实际上我们应该始终向 Krishna 祈祷的是，希望他能够赐予我们对他的爱。 这个就会让我们就是始终保持热情。明白吗？
One nice thing about all of you are is that just like a baby is going to eat whatever the father or mother feeds, whatever the mother feeds. The baby just opens its mouth and swallows.
那不论是父母给我们什么，我们只是一张嘴吃下去就完了。
So you are all like babies, baby birds with your mouth open.
所以你们大家每个人都像个婴儿似的，嘴张着嘴。So
I am very careful to only put in good things.
所以我呢就必须要特别的小心，只往你们嘴里放好东西。Because
I know whatever I put in, you're going to swallow.
因为我知道，无论我现在往你们嘴里放什么，你们都会吞下去的。So
I will try to only put the right one inside your mouth.
所以我要努力的只把好东西放到你们嘴里去。Second,
endeavoring with confidence.
第二条有利于做纯粹分爱服务的事情是满怀信心的努力。We
should be very confident to know, sure, we should feel confident that that the process of Krishna consciousness will work.
我们应该就是说特别坚定的相信那个 Krishna 意识它是要起作用的。Now
we see that maybe you have not seen in Taiwan, most of you, but generally we have seen around the world that many people take up Krishna consciousness for some time and then they leave the process and go away.
那也许我们台湾的奉献者现在还没有看到那种情况，但是呢，其他的世界的奉献者，他们已经看到了，就是在全世界有这样的情况，有很多人他可能这个来加入 Krishna 意识运动，完了过了一段时间就离开了。Why? 为什么？
If the process works, why do people leave?
既然那个程序是有效的，那人为什么离开呢？
If you are eating properly, then why do you get sick?
如果你吃的方法正确，东西都对的话，为什么你会病啊？
So you should not get sick if you're eating properly.
事实上，如果你真的吃对了的话，你不应该生病的。
And if you are following Krishna consciousness properly, then you should not give it up.
如果你培养就是我们就是正确的追寻那个培养 Krishna 意识的路的话，我们就会永远都不会放弃。So
what may cause people to give it up?
那到底是什么让人最后就是放弃培养 Krishna 意识？
Maybe they're not following properly.
也许是他们没有正确的追随那些教导。
Maybe they become mechanical in their chanting.
也许他们在念的时候变得是很机械的在念
They get no taste.
他们就没有得到那种品味
Why does that happen?
为什么会发生这样的事情呢?
Because of offenses
因为冒犯
One of the biggest, most important things is to have association with devotees
那么在我们培养Krishna意识过程当中 最重要的一件事情就是要跟奉献者联谊交往
But the danger of associating with devotees is that you can commit offenses
但是呢，跟奉献者交往联谊的那个危险在于，你有可能就冒犯奉献者。And
those offenses can check your purpose.
那如果那些冒犯的人呢，就会阻碍你的那个进步。So
yes, the process of Krishna consciousness works.
因此是的 ，Krishna 培养 Krishna 意识的程序是有效的。But
it has to be properly performed.
但是我们应该正确的去练习。
Without offenses.
在没有冒犯的情况下去练习。
It helps to see the example of advanced devotees. That gives us confidence.
那么看那些个就是进步的奉献者，有助于我们的进步。
One of the meanings of teacher is to teach by example.
那个老师的意思，一个意思就是说要以身作则，这个会给我们信心。
If we see that the teacher is always remaining confident under all conditions. Remaining determined, that will be the next, or being patient and remaining determined. This gives us the confidence we need.
当我们看到我们的老师，无论发生什么情况，一直是满怀信心，而且保持耐心的话，我们自己就会有信心。
Rupa Goswami says that you have, the next point is, the third one is to be patient.
那个Rupa Goswami在下一个要点里头，就是第三点里就说要有耐心。
Prabhupada gives as an example of patience a new bride.
那那个帕普帕德呢，给这个有关耐心的一个新的解啊啊，就是他用那个刚刚结婚新婚的夫妻来解释那个耐心。
When a girl first becomes married, she may immediately want to have a baby.
那个新娘子刚结婚以后，她可能想马上就有一个孩子。
But the baby takes time.
但是要想有孩子是需要时间的。
She has to be patient. It may take 9-10 months.
她必须要保持耐心，因为怀孕她需要九个月十个月。
So how long does it take for Krishna consciousness to develop?
那么要培养 Krishna 意识需要多长时间呢？
It may happen very quickly.
也许是特别的快。
Or it could take a lifetime.
也许呢，我们要花一生的时间。
It may take more than a lifetime.
也许我们要花不止一生的时间。
How patient are we?
那要看我们的耐心了。
If we don't practice patience, there will be no success in spiritual life.
如果我们不练习耐心的话，我们在灵性生活上不可能取得成功。
Any endeavor requires. This type of any success in any endeavor requires this sort of patience.
无论我们做什么事情，我们要想获得成功的话，都需要耐心。
Rupa Goswami says you have to be prepared to patiently endure all of the karma burning itself away, the karma that has accrued. From this lifetime and previous lifetimes, you must be patient enough to let it burn away.
Rupa Goswami 就说，我们必须要耐心的等待我们前生还有今生所自己制造的那个业报啊，能够最后被燃烧掉，必须耐心。
Every one of us is struggling with different types of impressions. Or different types of natures which we are born with and which we have developed in this lifetime.
我们每一个人呢，都在跟我们这个就是呃， 出生就有的那个本性，或者是在这一生所培养出来的一些个个性啊，去挣扎。
We remain patient gradually, those things will be finished up.
如果我们能够保持耐心的话，那么我们这些个不好的东西就会离开。
Prabhupada gives the example of the fan.
那帕布帕德就用这个电扇举了个例子。
If you turn off the switch, the fan does not stop immediately.
你看这个电扇现在转，当我们把那个钮给关上的话，它不是马上就停止的。
Slowly, it gradually slows down.
它是逐渐逐渐的慢下来。
In the same way, when you start to practice Krishna consciousness, you are turning off the switch of sinful life.
同样的道理，当我们开始培养Krishna意识的时候呢，我们等于就是把那个从事罪恶活动的那个钮就给关上。You
are turning off the switch of karma.
那也就是把那个业报的那个钮给关上了。But
it will take some time for the fan to stop.
但是呢，这个转动的电扇如果要停止的话，它需要一段时间。
The next thing is we should act according to the regulative principles of hearing and chanting and remembering Krishna, etc.
第四项有利于履行纯粹的奉爱服务的事项是按规范守则行事，例如聆听歌唱和铭记Krishna.
Have you translated the book Nectar of Devotion?
Yes.
In 2 or 3 months, you will have the book Nectar of Devotion.
在两三个月以后，我们大家就能够看到中文的那个奉爱的甘露。This
book is very important.
这本书非常的重要。It
tells you how to practice Krishna consciousness step by step.
它告诉我们怎么样能够一步一步的循序渐进的培养Krishna意识。So
we need to focus on hearing chanting Krishna's name. These are the two most important of all devotional activities.
那我们应该集中注意力的吟诵、聆听、吟诵、吟唱至尊主的圣名，这个是最重要的那个程序。
Actually, there's nothing more important than good hearing and chanting of Krishna's name.
事实上，没有什么别的事情比专注的。 聆听、吟诵、吟唱神的圣名更重要的。
You should know that when you chant your 16 rounds every day, this is the main service of your life.
你应该知道，大家应该知道，就是每天专注的吟诵、吟唱这个 Hare Krishna mantra 16圈， 这个是我们灵性生活最重要的一件事情。
Don't be foolish. Think that all my other services are more important.
不要愚蠢地认为我其他的服务比这项服务更重要。The
taste that you get in hearing and chanting will make you strong and keep you fixed in Krishna consciousness. It will give you everything that you want.
你就是通过这个专注的吟诵吟唱 Hare Krishna mantra 所给予你的那个品味呢，它能够使你就是。 一直不断地保持下去，而且呢，最后得到你所要得到的一切。The
next one is to give up the association of non-devotees.
下一项有利于奉爱服务的事项是不与非奉献者联谊。We
each have many materialistic friends and relatives. We each.
啊，我们每一个人。 都有这个家人呐、亲人，这个物质世界的。
As I said to you yesterday, maintain some relationship if you must.
那个就像我昨天说的，就是如果必要的话，那我们应该跟我们的家人呢保持一定的关系。
Don't let that association affect your spiritual life.
但是千万不要让我们跟家人的那种关系啊，最后影响我们的灵修生活。You
have a duty to your relatives. You have a duty to your friends. You have a duty to the country that you live in.
你有责任，就是对你的家人，对你的这个团体。 国家都有责任,
but not if the duty compromises your spiritual life.
但是所有这些个责任都不应该使我们, 就是降低我们的灵修生活。
Just like you may have father and mother to take care of.
就像比方说我们有那个父母需要照顾,
or children to take care of.
或者有孩子需要照顾。
But if by taking care of them you have to sacrifice the principles of Krishna consciousness, that is not possible.
但是如果说为了照顾他们，我们必须要牺牲，就是培养Krishna意识的那些个原则的话， 那个就不对了。
Because then you are harming them, not only yourself, you're harming them because they are standing in the way of bhakti, and you're allowing them to commit offenses toward the process of bhakti.
如果你那么做的话，实际上你就不仅仅是在伤害自己，你也在伤害你的家人。因为你的家人他站在你培养Krishna意识做父爱服务的那个路上在阻碍你。你如果允许他们去阻碍你的话，你等于就允许让他们去做冒犯。So
touching the feet of your father and mother, or touching the head of your son or daughter, you should tell them, I love you very much. But I cannot compromise my practice of Krishna consciousness. So you please don't mind, but I'm going to do what I must do for Krishna.
当我们在做父爱服务的过程当中，他们如果阻碍我们的话，那我们就应该就是触碰我们父母亲的脚，或者是抚摸着我们那个孩子的头，跟他们讲说， 我非常抱歉，我很爱你们，但是呢，你们现在在就是阻碍我做这个奉爱服务，而我呢不能够就是说去，因为你们的阻碍就不做了，所以我很抱歉。At
the time of death, when you have no more time left to do anything for anyone but yourself, you will practice Krishna consciousness.
当我们就是快死的时候，我们已经跟其他人，就是已经为其他人已经做了很多事情。那个时候只给我们留了那么一点点时间，我们呢要培养Krishna意识。But
we have seen that sometimes people, even at the time of death, they are more concerned for their family members.
但是呢，我们看到很多的人在他快死的时候，他最多的想的是他的家人。
Even though they are leaving this world and they cannot do anything for their family.
尽管呢，他就马上快要离开这个世界了，他被他的家人什么都做不了。
But there's so much attached.
但是他们是那么的执着和依恋。
That means we have to practice now giving our attention to Krishna and training ourselves and our family members, preparing them for the fact that Krishna is the first family member and all others follow Krishna.
我们应该就是从现在开始就练习，尽量的就是把注意力放在Krishna身上，而不是说全都放在这个家人的身上。这样的话，在我们的死的时候，我们才有能力不去执着和依恋，能够轻易的离开。
If some family or friends, if some friends who you used to have are really not interested in spiritual life and they are not willing to take interest in what you want to teach them about Krishna, what should you do?
那么如果比方说我们有过去有好朋友， 而这些好朋友不管我们怎么样的向他就是传播这个知识，他们都不感兴趣，我们该怎么办？
Give them a chance for a while.
应该给他们一段时间的机会。
But I think after some time, the friendship may cool off a little.
那我认为呢，过了一段时间以后， 你和你的朋友的这个友谊啊，就会这个温度就会降低。
Because you will no longer share common interests.
因为你跟他呢，就是再也没有那种共同的话题呀，等等兴趣可以分享。
So you must be prepared for this.
所以大家应该有心理准备对这一点。Our
experience is that you will lose some of your friends.
那我们的体验是，在这个培养Krishna意识过程当中，我们可能就会失去一些朋友。
And you'll make some new friends.
那可是呢，你可以去交一些新朋友。
So it's not so bad.
所以也不坏。
But this will happen.
但是呢，这样的情况会发生。
And you have to be prepared for that.
而大家呢，应该为此做准备。
Krishna consciousness is a change within ourselves.
那个 Krishna 意识，它是使我们从内在就开始改变。
And we will change because of Krishna consciousness.
我们因为培养 Krishna 意识，就会改变。
But I have seen that if you remain friendly with people, even if they're not devotees, then gradually they will be influenced in a proper way.
当然，但是我呢看到的情况就是说，只要你跟人保持这个友好的关系，那尽管他们不培养Krishna意识，可是逐渐的随着时间的流失，他们就会逐渐的发生变化。You
can be patient.
你应该耐心。
The main point is that they should not influence you with their materialistic ways. You don't have to stop being with them, but if you cannot avoid their materialistic habits by being with them, then you may have to give up their association. But if you're strong enough, you can keep associating with them, and gradually you will influence them.
关键的问题是，我们在跟这些个世俗的人啊朋友交往的时候，不应该让他们来影响我们。如果我们不是那么坚强、比较脆弱的话， 他们的那些个不好的习惯来影响到我们的话，我们就应该最后要放弃跟他们的这种交往。但如果我们足够的坚强，我们可以影响他们，给予他们联谊的话，那我们就保持友好关系。And
the last principle is to follow in the footsteps of the previous acaryas.
那最后一项有利于履行纯粹的奉爱服务的事项是向前辈 acarya 灵性导师学习。
You see in that room.
大家看那个房间,
the pictures.
那个房间墙上画的照片,
and on our altar in your temple.
还有我们那个每一个中心庙宇里面的那个,
the pictures of the gurus.
神坛上都有灵性导师的照片,
we have to follow their footsteps.
我们必须向他们学习, 追随他们。
You can learn about them.
我们可以就是学习他们的榜样,
and what they have done.
我学习他们都曾经是怎么做的，他们是怎么说的。
And try to model your life after their example.
也就是说，要以他们为榜样来我们生活，在我们的生活中要以他们为榜样。
We have to learn from our guru.
我们必须要跟我们的灵性导师学习。
But we may not do everything that our guru does.
但是呢，我们也许不能够，就是说，我们灵性导师做什么，我们也做什么。
But we should learn the spirit in which he does those things.
我们应该学习呢，就是说他做这些个事情所怀有的那种精神，我们要学习。
Because each person's service is unique to that person.
那个，因为什么呢？因为每一个人的这个服务啊，都是跟他个人是有关系，是他个人做的服务。
But the mood in which the guru does his service is the mood that we want to learn to do our own.
但是呢，我们的灵性导师做他的那个服务所怀有的那个心态和精神，这个是我们要学习的。And
what is that mood?
那他的那个心态精神是什么呢？
You are very qualified. Anyone that can do two things at one time is very intelligent.
他说，谁要是能够同时做两件事情，就是很聪明的。
The mood that all that is the same in all of the gurus is. The same mood is in all of the gurus. What is that mood?
那么所有的灵性导师所共有的那个心态和精神是什么呢？
They are doing pure devotional service to Krishna.
他们在为 Krishna 做纯粹的奉爱服务。
Srila Prabhupada gives a very important point in the Bhagavad Gita.
那个圣帕布帕德在国家梵歌里面给了我们一个很重要的一个要旨。
That he says that his sole inspiration comes from serving his guru.
他唯一的那种灵感就是为他的灵性导师服务。
Someone asked Prabhupada, do you know Krishna?
那有些人就问Prabhupada说你知道Krishna吗?
No, I don't know Krishna. I only know my Guru Maharaj.
他不怕的就说不，我不知道Krishna，我唯一知道的是我的灵性导师。
That means that he knows Krishna through his guru.
这句话的意思是，他通过他的灵性导师了解 Krishna.
We had practical experience that we always would report to Prabhupada every week in a letter what we are doing, and we got so much inspiration knowing that he was pleased.
那我们呢，就是对Guru他们都有那个亲身的体验呢。 在他们做帕帕德在的时候，他们做管理工作的时候，他们每一个星期都给帕帕德用信汇报他们这一个礼拜做的什么事情。然后呢，通过帕帕德的回信，他们就那么的高兴，知道帕帕德就是对他们的服务是那么的满意。So
this is the way the spiritual master gives service or proves of service to the disciple. The disciple fulfills that service and pleases the guru and automatically makes advancement.
那这个就是我们的方法，就是灵性导师给予这个门徒具体的服务事项，而门徒通过完成灵性导师的指令去做这个服务，最后呢就是取悦灵性导师，这个就会使他的灵性就会进步。
By the mercy of the spiritual master, one gets the mercy of Krishna, and without the mercy of the spiritual master, no one can make any advancement at all.
那我们通过灵性导师的靠灵性导师的仁慈，我们才能够得到 Krishna 的仁慈。如果得不到灵性导师的仁慈的话，没有人能够在灵性路途上取得进步。
Any question?
有没有什么问题？
There are a number of ways to do that.
他说有很多方法可以做。
The easiest one is to associate with those who are strong.
最容易的一个方法是跟那些个信心坚定、强有力的人去联谊交往。
The strongest of all is Krishna. The strongest of all is Krishna.
那最这个强有力的人物就是 Krishna.
Prabhupada said, Krishna is great, and by serving the greatest, you also will become great.
那帕布帕德说，我们通过就是为那个强有力的人做服务的话，我们自己也会变得强有力。
Krishna is available to you through his holy names.
那 Krishna 呢？我们可以通过他的圣名来得到他。
Through his message, Bhagavad Gita.
可以通过他给我们的那个在国家范科里给我们的信息，我们可以得到他。
Through his pastimes and Srimad Bhagavatam.
可以通过圣典国家瓦坛里面描述的有关他的娱乐时光，我们可以得到他。
Through his remnants of food and his prasad.
我们可以通过得到这个 Krishna 吃剩下的那个食物 prasadam， 我们也可以得到 Krishna。
Yeah, through his devotees.
我们也可以通过 Krishna 的奉献者得到 Krishna。
In the form of his deity.
还可以通过看他的那个神像的这个形象。
All of these will make you so strong.
所有这些东西都可以使我们变得是那么的强壮的。
Yes, we we said that we should always endeavor to love Krishna. Is it possible to love Krishna if we've lost our love for our spiritual master?
那个这位塔布就问郭德夫说，郭德夫讲，我们应该始终的努力培养对 Krishna 的爱，去爱 Krishna。 但是如果我们失去了对我们灵性导师的爱的话，我们还有可能在对 Krishna 爱吗？爱 Krishna 吗
？I don't think that one loses love. Love is not something you can lose.
郭德夫说，我不认为说有失去爱这么一回事，爱它不是失去。Just
like Krishna consciousness is not something you can lose.
就像 Krishna 意识似的，并不是到时候会失去。You
may forget it.
你可能遗忘。It
may become covered.
也许呢，这个 Krishna 意识被遮盖住了。But
everyone is originally Krishna conscious.
但是我们每一个人原本就有 Krishna 意识。That
is our nature.
这个是我们的本性。So
we have simply forgotten Krishna.
我们现在只不过是忘了 Krishna。You
cannot lose Krishna.
你不可能失去 Krishna.
You can only forget Krishna.
你只有可能是忘了 Krishna.
Just like now, you can make believe it is night by closing your eyes.
那就像现在，我们通过闭眼睛，可能就会想啊，现在是黑天。But
as soon as you open your eyes, you know there's so much light; it is daytime.
但是呢，一旦我们睁开眼睛，我们看满屋子的光景，我们知道啊，今天实际上是现在是白天。
So generally, this type of misunderstanding is due to it is a misunderstanding due to ignorance.
所以呢，就是说，同样的道理，就是说，这个由于无明啊、无知啊，他才会误解。Krishna
is guru.
Krishna 就是灵性导师。
When you talk about the difference, is it possible to love Krishna if you've lost your love for guru? But Krishna is guru.
当你谈说失去对 guru 的灵性导师的爱，能不能爱 Krishna 的时候，实际上就错了，因为 Krishna 本人就是灵性导师。
Krishna is within our heart as Chaitya guru.
那个 Krishna 呢，他以 Chaitya guru 的形式在我们的心中。The
witness, the spirit, the paramatma, the witnessing soul who's within the heart, next to our own soul, is Krishna guiding us, our inner conscience.
那个超灵，那个一切的见证者，在我们心中的这个旁边的这，就是 Krishna.
You have a guru in your heart.
你本身就有一位灵性导师在你的心中。
Who guides you to do the right things?
他呢是指导你做这个对的事。
Every day you have to make so many decisions.
每天你要做那么多的决定。
Who's giving you the intelligence to make the right choice? That is Krishna as guru within the heart.
谁给你那个智慧，让你最后做决定去做对的事情啊？那个是 Krishna 灵性导师在你的心中给你的那个智慧。
Krishna appears outside also as the initiating guru.
那 Krishna 呢？他是以这个启迪灵性导师呢，在外在显现给你。
The person who gives you connection with the teachings of Krishna and connects you with the Chaitya guru in your heart.
那个启迪灵性导师就是教导你有关 Krishna 的知识，而且呢，让你跟 Krishna 能够连接上的那个人。
And Krishna appears also as the instructing guru, or even there may be more than one instructing guru.
那 Krishna 呢，也以这个训示灵性导师出现，而训示灵性导师呢，不是一个，他可能有很多。So
to say, how can I love Krishna if I have forgotten, lost my love for my guru? But Krishna is guru.
那所以我们 Krishna 就是我们的灵性导师。我们怎么能够说，如果我失去了对 guru 的爱，我还能不能爱 Krishna？ Krishna 就是灵性导师。
You have to understand that the guru is not an ordinary person, but he's the representative, the manifestation of Krishna.
我们必须要理解，灵性导师不是普通的人，他是 Krishna 的代表，是 Krishna 的扩展。
If we see him in an ordinary way, as separately from Krishna, that is not very good.
如果我们以这个就是平常的那种方式去看灵性导师，而且呢，就是把灵性导师跟 Krishna 分开那么看的话，那个是错的。
The Chaitanya Chaitamrita, it is said, Panchatattva, five truths in one.
Chaitanya Chaitamrita 里面就说，那个五圣体啊， Panchatattva 是一体。
Just like
五个真理,
Krishna Das Kaviraj says, one who tries to love Krishna, Lord Chaitanya, but does not love Lord Nityananda, can never love Lord Chaitanya. Similarly, if you don't love Advaitacharya, you cannot. Similarly, if you don't have love for Gadadhar and Srivas, you cannot. And similarly, if you don't have love for Guru, you cannot. These are all parts of the same truth. And not to see it that way is to misunderstand the philosophy.
就像那个什么嘎达那个，就是那个有一个伟大的奉献者就说了，如果一个人就是说在不爱尼提安南达爬布的情况下想爱柴达尼亚麻爬布，这个是不可能的。如果他在
就是五圣体里面的每一个人，他如果不去爱的话，他想去爱Chaitanya Mahaprabhu，这个是根本不可能的事情。所以要爱这个五圣体的爱，不是。We should not have a mundane vision of Guru.
我们对灵性导师不应该有那种用那个世俗的眼光去看。A sentimental
view of the Guru.
我们不应该以那种就是感情用事的那种眼光去看。In
the beginning, it may be sentimental.
在一开始可能是感情用事,
but gradually through understanding the teachings and by surrendering our life, that should come to a proper understanding that the Guru is the mercy incarnation of Krishna.
那随着我们不断的进步，我们就不应该总是保持在一个感情用事的阶段，而是应该通过遵循灵性导师的训示，来 明白，就是说 Krishna 灵性导师是 Krishna 的那个代表和扩展。Another
question.
仁慈。Another
question.
有没有另外一个问题？What's
the difference between Krishna's incarnation and his teaching?
他问 Krishna 的化身和扩展之间有什么区别？
Yeah. To incarnate means to appear, to descend. The word is avatar. It means to descend into this world.
化身意思是那个avatar，意思是降临到这个世界。So
some of the expansions of Krishna remain in the spiritual world. And some of the expansions of Krishna descend into this world.
那 Krishna 的有一些个扩展呢，始终在灵性世界里面；有一些个扩展呢，就化身降临到这个物质世界。Someone
may be an expansion of Krishna, as well as an incarnation of Krishna. And some expansions don't come in this world; they just remain in the spiritual world.
Krishna 的有一些个扩展呢，他也许根本就从不降临到这个物质世界，他一直在灵性世界里边。有一些呢，他就来到这个世界。Have
you translated teachings of Lord Chaitanya yet? Is the book available? Okay. You have to read teachings of Lord Chaitanya. This will explain it very clearly.
如果你想明白这一点的话，你应该认真的去读 Chaitanya 的教导，这个就会让你明白。It
explains the different types of incarnations, different types of expansion. This is the right book to read.
那这个柴达尼亚教导里面的详细的解释了那个至尊主的不同的化身、不同的扩展。And
always remember that Krishna is the source of all of them.
而且应该要永远记住 Krishna 是所有这些化身和扩展的源头。How
do you like seeing Radha Madhava and the gopis?
你们对那个就是看到那个 Radha Madhava 神像，还有那些个牧牛姑娘，有多喜欢呢？
非常喜欢。What about Lord Nrisimha Dev?
那个主女性啊 Dev
呢？Is he scary?
他是不是让你们感到挺可怕的呀？
No. I think we'll stop. Because it's 9:30 and we're shot on time. confession. So we will go, what happened with, where is the sugar one? Is someone going to tell him that he should bring? Anyway, if you find him, then we will do, otherwise we'll just go for lunch. It's up to you to find him. Okay? And you have to